Good morning, sir. So, in this presentation and in this project, we are set to build a board game which is played online or a physical board game through which coding is not had been done yet. So, creation of a digital board game was a very big task to perform, and choosing one of the board games was also a bit difficult. So, like, there were three games in my mind: Align 3, Peg Solitary, and 4-in-a-line. So, Peg Solitary and 4-in-a-line, I do have them in my home and I play with it. They are both amazing and fun. And Align 3 was a game which my grandfather told me. But when I discussed it with the instructor, it was a bit difficult to get it through a code. So, this was rejected. Then, Peg Solitary was like, the code was already present, and I couldn't perform that. So the next one was 4-in-a-line. So when I went into depth of 4-in-a-line and saw the objective and how it could be made, so I found that interesting and gave a thumbs up in about to do this game. So this game is basically a vertical board which has 42 windows distributed in 7 hollow columns and 6 rows. Each column has a hole in the upper part of the board where pieces are introduced. So one by one, we need to put each point in through the board from the top. And one player is allowed to put only one coin at a time per turn. So 21 piece coins are given to both the players. Then the rules of the game are like, each player is assigned with 21 checkers, as I told, and drops one coin per turn at a time. Then a winner is declared if the player gets 4 colored checkers of his chosen color, 4 in a line, either horizontal, vertical, or diagonal, then he's the winner. If none of them gets a winner and the whole board gets filled up, then it's a draw. And as soon as the winner is declared, the game is drawn. The grid is set, is reset. So, giving a solution to this problem is not very easy. Like, whatever the problem or the game I chose to put for a solution was not easy at all. Like, to every problem, there can't be a solution at instant. So, first we need to figure out what all is needed in the game, what should be there, what should not be there, the pros and cons, then the ideation, strategy, objective, goals, what all is needed in the program, all is supposed to be there. So the stages which were involved in solving the game computationally were so the first part was the decomposition part. Breaking down a problem into a set of smaller problems was the motive of decomposition. So first, I thought of making a default background for the GUI. Then, make a grid of 6 rows and 7 columns as per the game which I have, and which is the basic default size of the grid. Then, try to place the coins one after the other on the grids provided. That too, not on the top, but on the end of the grid, starting from the end and then piling it one at a time. Next step was pattern recognition. So in the pattern recognition part, I think the logic of the game settled. Like, if 4 coins in a row, be it horizontal, vertical, or diagonal, be there, that time the game was won. So that was the part where pattern recognition was seen. Then talking about abstraction, I think if the game is won, no further chances are given to the player to put the coins, and the game is completed and it ends over there, no further moves are allowed, and the game resets to its original grid as soon as there's a draw or someone wins the game. And then talking about the algorithm was divided into two. First one was the GUI of the front page, the window page, through which frames were connected, and through them when buttons or widgets were clicked, then they were navigated to to the grid of the game. So first, to make the home, window page, I was instructed to make the outline of the page, like where the widget will be placed, what should be on the top, what should be the size of the window, the frame. So that was done first. Then after doing that, then we came to the grid part. So first, a sample with a grid was made through 6 rows and 7 columns. Then I thought, rather than making a simple plain grid, why not go into the actual representation of the grid, like with the ovals and then the color inserted into that. So there was a method in tkinter which said create oval through the instance of the class. So I did use that, and through that I got a window to be placed. So I like to share that. So as I said earlier, game instructions should be shown through a button widget. So I did make this, and it says welcome to 4-in-a-line game, and as the outline stated, start, quit, instructions. So this is where the home page was created. So when I click on the start tab, the game, this page is seen, and when I click on the back, so the final window, this is the window where the game is seen. This is the first class window size is for the window framing. Then the shape is for the inner frame, which will be the oval sized window. Then the position of coins, like will it be at position at the top when it is clicked, or will it be at the bottom, the last row, and then get piled up. Then this method is for the color equality, like if it is blank, then the black is first inserted. If not, then red. Then we check for, we say red turn, black turn, chance by chance. Then for the horizontal, vertical and diagonal lines. And this is the method through which the whole tkinter program works. So when I run it, this pops up, so say start game. So black, whoever has black coins plays the first. So the red, now it says red turn, then again it says black, then it's red, black, the red wins. So when I click on the restart, it gets restarted to the blank grid. So this is, so sir, this was the presentation. And then difficulties which I faced was a lot. Like first, would I be able to represent the game which I have the same way which I could do it digitally? So that was good. Then the part for the checking if the 4 points of the same color are in line or not. The vertical and horizontal was easy, like during the merging part for the previous assignments. I was able to do, but the diagonal part was a bit difficult. So help from the net and through my friend, I did it. And the links of the references are there in the documentation. Then I still have some difficulties which I could not solve till now. Like the one, when the button is clicked of start, the file which I have made and which I have imported into the main file, it is not getting called. So I have to resolve that. So that's it. Thank you, sir.